This tutorial outlines required steps NMR users must take to safely handle NMR samples in our facility. The protocol begins in your laboratory, where you are preparing your NMR tube. Rule 1. You must wear goggles when handling chemicals. Rule 2. A fire retardant lab coat. Most of NMR solvents are highly flammable. Rule 3. Wear appropriate protective gloves. You will be placing your sample solution in a standard 5mm NMR tube. Please pay attention that you only use tubes 8-inch or shorter in our NMR facility. Your compound should be dissolved in a deuterated solvent. The minimum volume of a sample is 0.6 milliliters. It is time to load your sample. To put your sample in the NMR tube, you may use a long needle or a 13-inch long tip pipette. I put a rubber bulb on the top. I take a sample solution into my pipette and load it to the bottom of the NMR tube. As I expel solution from the pipette, I also gradually withdraw the pipette out of the tube, following the rise of a solution column. Now I close the tube and push on a cap to make sure it is tightly sealed. My next step is very important. I must clean outside surface of the NMR tube to remove residue of any chemicals. I will grab a tissue and carefully wipe the tube and a cap. Next step is to remove your gloves. Gloves must stay in the lab because they may carry a residue of chemicals. Remember, gloves are prohibited in all NMR rooms. Is this the time to go to the NMR room? Not quite yet. Watch closely. What's wrong with this picture? We are not allowed to carry unprotected NMR tubes outside of a lab to the NMR room. I must use a secondary container to prevent the tube from breaking and spilling a sample if it is dropped on the floor. You may purchase inexpensive NMR tube carriers like these, or use a homemade one, as long as it securely closes the tube during transport. Here is the carrier I will use. It is a plastic tube with cap on both ends and some foam to cushion the tube. I take off the cap, place my NMR tube inside, close, and it is now really ready for transporting to the NMR room. What am I doing? Stop! This is just another reminder. No gloves outside your lab and in NMR rooms. When you come to the NMR room with your sample, it is important that you bring your goggles. You do not have to put them on just yet, while your sample is enclosed in a secondary container, NMR tube carrier. Our next step is to take the sample out. First thing to do, goggles on. Now it is safe to take the sample out of the NMR tube carrier. When inserting your sample in a spinner, it is important not to hold the spinner with your hand. Instead, I insert the tube in a spinner directly in a spinner rack. Next step is to set a correct depth, again, without any touching. Sample is ready for loading in the sample changer. If you still need to hold onto the spinner, you must use a tissue to prevent a direct contact with the spinner. Reason to these precautions? If a spinner carries a little bit of grease, sweat, dust to the probe, it stays in the probe. At some point, the instrument loses ability to spin. To avoid this problem, remember, no touching the spinner. One last check that you want to do before the sample goes into the instrument is to verify that your sample height is sufficient for good shimming. The height of the solution must be no lower than 40 mm. If you loaded 0.6 ml of solution just a moment ago in your lab, you are all set. If your tube was sitting for a while, you should check the height, because most solvents will evaporate even from the closed tube. If your sample height is shorter than 40 mm, top shim will fail. You will have bad peak shapes and poor resolution in the spectrum. All is good. We now can place the sample with a spinner into a sample changer and go to the workstation. This is a point when it is safe to take off the goggles. When you are done with your experiment and are ready to pick up your sample, the first thing to do is to put on your goggles. I pick my sample from a changer. To take the spinner off without touching it, I take a tissue, point my tube into an empty slot in a spinner rack, and push the spinner off the tube with the tissue. My final step is to put a sample tube into my NMR tube carrier. Put a cap on to close the carrier. At this point, the sample is securely enclosed in the NMR tube carrier. You may take off your goggles. Your NMR room visit is complete.